Pass and welcome to COVID-19 Lab, or as I call it, Lab Methods. I want to take a moment to provide a little bit of insight on our practical. Some of you may have addressed your concerns without not having access to gym equipment, which is fine. We can use rotational weights. The other thing I wanted to provide here is a little bit of structure. So obviously our unit we're covering is Unit8Pullup. So while doing this, I'm going to offer a little bit of a demonstration how we would like to see the practical. So, start with your introduction. Hi, I'm Sean Mathis, and I'm here to talk about the pull-up exercise. So there's two main reasons that we do pull-ups. One, promotes good posture, and two, it strengthens the primary movers, which is the latissimus dorsi. So the reason you want to have good posture is it allows us for pulling motions to stabilize the scapula, as well as corrective posture, which poor posture can cause pain and inhibit breathing, as well as decrease efficiency of other organs and functions. When discussing exercises, it's important to biomechanically understand what the movement involves. So during the pull-up exercise, the main joint actions that we have are extension and adduction of the glenohumeral joint. We have flexion of the elbow, bending the elbow, bringing our body up to the bar, and downward rotation and retraction of the scapula. Retraction also is known as adduction, and downward rotation also known as medial rotation. We have trunk stabilization to the anatomical core. Our prime mover is the latissimus dorsi, one of the largest muscles in the human body. There's a multitude of synergistic muscles being involved as well, everything from the biceps, the triceps, the teres major, rotator cuff muscles, serratus anterior, and the list goes on. The synergistic muscles, it's more important to know what other main muscle groups are involved. Obviously, we know our grip, our forearm, our shoulder is going to be heavily involved because that's one of the joints that takes place. So the little muscles surrounding those joints, it's important to understand that they do have a role, not necessarily be able to memorize and listen. So our setup for the pull-ups, we want to grab the bar a little bit wider than shoulder width, a little bit of elbow flexion, we're going to dead hang. From there, we're going to look up, big breath, big pull, start to pull. Some of the common flaws often seen are limited range of motion, lack of scapular stability, lack of trunk stability, overly or excessive swinging, sweating, or kicking. Kipping if it's not sport specific for you. And just not being strong enough for the exercise. It is an advanced exercise for a lot of people. Especially if you have a higher body weight, it's going to be increasingly more difficult. And also with that, more risky or likely to be injured in the shoulder. So the lack of scapular stability will be presented as a complete collapse of the upper back. So what we want to do to correct that is have them cue them up with big chest or squeeze the upper back, bring the shoulder blades back, any one of those works, and then drive the elbows down and back. Lack of core stability will be seen as a collapse in the upper back and hips, and it will also be shown in swaying. So similar to the lack of scapular stability, we want to just tell them tight gut, tight butt, big breath. Then drive the elbows down and back. The limited range of motion is pretty clear if they're not getting full extension or full concentric or eccentric action, then that exercise is probably just a bit too advanced. In the next part of this video, we're going to talk about some progressions, making it from... Next, we're going to talk about progressions, starting from the easiest exercise to the most difficult with pull-ups. We are limited on what we can demonstrate here, but one of them would be, actually the very first one, would be a lat pull-down. So the lat pull-down puts the body in the safest position to learn the movement. The body weight is supported obviously on the stool, and then you'll bring down the weight to you. Once you get close to your body weight with that exercise, typically it's a good indication that you're ready to progress to a pull-up, but with that there's other steps as well. So from the lat pull-down, we have the anti-gravity machine. I'll post some pictures up in the anti-gravity machine because obviously I don't have one here. From there we go into a spotter or band assistant pull-up. The band assistant pull-up, there's really two ways we can do it. One, we can set up with a J-hook or the safety arms, just put the band around, take the same grip, step over the band, set up as the same, coaching cues are the same, bring back down. Very little changes, which is what makes us a pretty valuable progression or regression. From there, we go into the partner-assisted pull-up. That's simply if you hips, have a spine just beneath the shoulder blades, and assisting all the way up, just like we talked about in lecture on Tuesday. The reason we don't necessarily want to spot the feet is you and your spotter may not know when you're going to let go or what would happen in the case that you did just simply let go of the bar and they didn't let go of your feet. So you, anytime there's another person, that communication becomes important and increase the risk of injury. From there, we have a full pull-up, and then finally a weighted pull-up. The common flaws are very similar in all of these variations that can be seen on the slide deck of the lecture. And the coaching cues also are the same as well. So the main takeaway is always going to be to have a tight core, very engaged upper back, squeeze the shoulder blades, and think about pulling